Hello students, welcome to official YouTube channel of Spardha Academy. This is Shailendra Mohan and in this video lesson, I am going to discuss a topic of general science in biology, which is known as tissue biology, right? Tissue is an important system in our body, which is required for the various functions in the body, right? So what is the use of tissue, why this tissue is being incorporated in the body, and how the questions are formed in various examinations, right? Because there are various examinations like UPSC, SSC and UPSSC examinations. UPSSC examination has particularly asked some of the important questions on tissues, and so as SSC and UPSC. In UPSC, if you see CDS examination paper or FCAT examination paper, they are asking very good questions from this topic, right? Even CSC examinations also ask some very good examination questions. So you need to understand the thing, what is tissue? And it is basically your human body system. This is your system which requires general purpose thinking and also require and also help us to perform various functions, right? So we should know about the tissue. What is tissue and how this help us in a help our body to incorporate various functions of the body, right? So I hope that after learning from this lesson, you will be able to answer all the questions of tissues, and this will help you in cracking various examination from this particular topic, right? So all the very best, keep learning and do share the lessons, right? Let us start the lessons. Here we go. So we are talking about tissue, right? Tissue is nothing but the assembly of cell. What it is? It is the assembly of cell. Okay? Assembly of cell. Assembly of cell ka matlab bas simple sa itna hai that it simply means that similar cells performing similar functions. This simply means that if you are having a cell, right? If you are having a cell, these cells combine with each other. There is a cluster of various cells and these are similar cells, right? Similar cells, they will combine together and they will form a particular function. Only one function, one particular function, right? One particular function. If they are performing one particular function, then this is known as what? This is known as tissue, right? Tissue ho jata hai wo, theek hai? Kyun aisa ho raha hai? Why this is happening? Because in our body system, we have like say we have heart, theek hai? We have cardiac. This is scientifically known as cardiac, right? Cardiac. Now cardiac have a muscle. It is a muscular tissue, and this muscle is a special type of muscle. This is a special type of muscle, a special type which do not present in any of the body part, which is not present in any of the body part except the cardiac. Right now this muscle has a unique function of contraction and relaxation, continuous contraction and relaxation, because our heart starts pumping from the day we born and after 2 hours of our death. It continues to work like this. Constant contraction and relaxation occurs in this muscles, right? So this is a special type of muscle which requires constant working, constant mitochondria, constant energy levels, constant blood supply. Now this muscle is important to us, right? Now this, if this muscle is taken out from the body and placed on hand, will it work like our hand work, or the hand will be able to work like today it is working? No, because this muscle is specialized for cardiac, not for hand. So what I am saying that key important thing is that tissue is a structure which is required for a particular function, and this is unique, right? One tissue perform one type of function. Like we say, we have to move. Now for moving, we need muscles and bones. Now bones and muscles together combine to form a movable or locomotive organs. Okay, locomotive organs, and these locomotive organs help the human body to travel, right? So these are the combination of tissues. Now bone is other tissue and muscle is other tissue. If you are talking about the sensation of the body, if you are talking about sensation in the body, now sensation in the body, how this travels? Now, sensation happens in the mind, right? If you are getting like someone pricked your finger, right? So your finger should be removed. And how this comes from comes to you? This comes to you from the brain system, right? And brain given the instruction. Now, this instruction is traveled from brain to this finger. Now, this finger receives the signals via nervous system, right? Nervous system. Now, this nervous system helped us. This nervous system is a tissue, right? If a neuron, if a single neuron get degraded, there will no sensation. And no sensation means if your finger is cut, there is no sensation. You will feel, you will not feel any type of pain, right? And for example, if you think of other example like skin. Skin is also a tissue which is found in human system, and this is known as epithelial tissue. Epithelial word ka matlab hi hota hai cover. This is covering of the tissue, right? Covering of the tissue means that simply there is a skin, and skin is impervious to water and various other components, like if you apply gel or any other thing, if it is impervious to it, so it will not allow its gel to move inside the body, right? Impervious to water, impervious to various other things. If you apply various things on the skin, hardly any small things goes inside the skin, other is not. Apart from the skin, just below the skin, there is adipose tissue, right? In human system, if this is all in human system. And if you come in plant system there is two type of systems, right? There is meristematic tissue and there is permanent tissue, right? Meristematic tissue in Hindi, it is known as vibhajyota kutak, and this is responsible for the division of cells, right? Division of cells. This forms the basic structural utility in the plants. This has the power of division, while permanent do not have the power of division. So in tissue, we will study all these things in very detail, and the questions are being asked from these type of questions. These type of options are made, and you should know about the things, what they are actually, right? So in the next slide, we will study about the tissue. Now, the study of tissue. Study of tissue is known as histology. This is very important question. Histology. Now, this is being asked in reasoning also. ठीक है, इन एनालॉजी, एनालॉजी के पेपर में या एनालॉजी में ये चीज पूछ ली जाती है, व्हाट इज द स्टडी ऑफ टिश्यू नोन एज. इंग्लिश में भी ये चीज पूछी गई है. इन इंग्लिश दे हैव आस्क्ड वन वर्ड सब्स्टिट्यूशन एंड वन वर्ड सब्स्टिट्यूशन फॉर टिश्यू स्टडी. दिस इज नोन एज हिस्टोलॉजी, राइट? अब व्हाई टिश्यू हैज कम इन द एग्जिस्टेंस, इट हैज कम इन द एग्जिस्टेंस बिकॉज ऑफ द प्रेजेंस ऑफ डिविजन ऑफ लेबर, डिविजन ऑफ लेबर, राइट? In Hindi, it is known as Shram ka Vibhajan. What? Shram ka Vibhajan. Shram ka Vibhajan. It simply means that hand can do the work of the work that is designated to it. It cannot be used to walk, used for walking. Legs are made for walking, for locomotion. They cannot be used for writing unless until you expertise in that, right? So, division of labor means some work has been designated to the various parts of the body and they have to do that part, right? If the lungs has a part of respiration, so you cannot respirate through ears, you cannot respirate through nose, eyes, you cannot respirate through hands, right? This respiration has been designated to lungs. Now lungs has the power of respiration and they will do that, right? Inhalation and exhalation is a part of respiration, it is not a part of locomotion, right? And the digestive system, this is the another part, and it has a division of labor of digestion of body, digestion of food materials. So where there is the division of labor, there is tissue, okay? And this division of labor comes in multicellular organisms are the organisms that have more than one cell, and unicellular organism do not have division of labor. They do not have division of labor because only single cell is there. Only single cell, and this single cell will help only one person, only one thing, that all the functions has to be done by this single cells. There is locomotion, same cell will do. Exocytosis, pinocytosis, endocytosis, all the functions are being done by single cell. There is no division of labor. But in multicellular organism, there is a division of labor, right? So division of labor is the important factor of what? tissue, right? Tissue has there, if tissue is there, there will be a division of liver. If there is no tissue, there is no division of liver, right? Now we are going to talk about the classification of tissue, right? Now the classification of tissue, if you talk about the classification, this is very important. Classification of tissue. If you talk about the classification of tissue, the tissue has been divided into two parts. It's very easy and not very complicated, right? One is known as plant tissue and another is known as animal tissue. Okay. We are not going to talk about the unicellular organism because there is no tissue and there is the wastage of time. We are talking about the multicellular organism that have division of labor, and the study of tissue is known as histology. We are talking about plant tissue and the animal tissue. Now the plant tissue has been divided into two parts, right? Now this is very important because the question is being asked from these options also. One is known as meristematic tissue and one is known as permanent tissue, right? Meristematic has the power of division. They have the power of division, okay? And they do not have the power of this permanent do not have the power of division do not have power of division okay they do not have the power of division confirm now this meristematic tissue has been divided into three parts. If we talk about the meristematic tissue, this is divided into three parts. One is apical meristem, one is lateral meristem, and one is intercalary meristem. And this permanent tissue has been divided into two categories. One is simple permanent tissue and another is complex permanent tissue. This simple permanent tissue is further divided into three parts. One is parenchyma, another is sclerenchyma, and then it is collenchyma. Okay, this is divided into three parts: parenchyma, sclerenchyma, and collenchyma. This complex cell is been divided, your complex tissue is been divided into xylem and phloem. Okay, now this is known as vascular bundle. In plants, this is known as vascular system, right? They help in the transmission of various food materials from one part to the another part of in the plant, right? And they form the internal structure of the plant. Internal structure means wood. If they are ek question aur pucha jata, wood is formed by, so that is formed by xylem. Okay, ye xylem banane ka kaam karta hai, and the wood, the internal structure of the wood is being formed by parenchyma, sclerenchyma, and collenchyma. And this meristematic tissue help in the division or the increase in the length or breadth of the plant. Okay, so this is known as meristematic tissue and they have the power of division. Now if we talk about the animal tissue, right, this animal tissue is being divided into four parts. Okay, one is known as epithelial tissue, another is known as muscular tissue, another is known as nervous tissue, and the last is known as connective tissue. This is very important tissue, connective tissue. The question is being asked from epithelial tissue, muscular tissue, nervous tissue, and the connective tissue. All the questions have been asked from these parts, and also question being asked from meristematic tissue and the permanent tissue. Okay, and further in permanent tissue they have asked the maximum questions on the complex tissue, like in xylem and phloem, and they are also known as what? Vascular system, yeah, vascular bundles. They are also known as vascular bundle in plants. Okay, they help in the transmission of various food materials, waters, minerals from root to the shoot system and to the various other parts of the plant. Right now, we should start learning about them in one by one way. Okay, now firstly, we will talk about the plant tissue system. Plant tissues. Okay, plant tissue. Now plant tissue में अगर आप देखो तो one is meristematic tissue means they have the power of division. Okay, if they have the power of division means they are responsible for the increase of the length, increase in the breadth, and increase in the overall system of the plant. Okay, if we think about the part, like if I say that this is the plant, this is the ground, okay, this is ground. Now here we have one shoot system. This is known as shoot, and below it there is a root system. Okay, if you think, simply think about that, this is the shoot system, root system. Okay, now if we think about the meristematic tissue where they are present, if I talk about this position, okay, now if I talk about this position, this position, this position, okay, now this is known as this, and these are termed as apical meristem. Apical meristem, these meristem help in increase in length, increase in length, okay, increase in length of the plant. Now if I talk about the lateral meristem, laterals means the sides of the plant, lateral means the side of the plant. If you talk about like this, this here, side maybe, all from the sides, now this is known as, these are known as lateral meristem, lateral meristem, and they help in increase in breadth, increase in breadth. Now if there is an increase in breadth, there is an increase in length. Now the plant has increased in length, plant has increased in breadth. Now what is the important point here? If we increase the length of the plant and breadth of the plant, there will be a hollow sphere in there. There will be a hollow space here and also at the branching system. Now the branching system occurs. This branching system also needs some tissues, some special type of tissues. So here the tissues are known as intercalary meristem. Intercalary meristem. Okay, intercalary meristem. These are found in forming branches. They help in form in the formation of branches, right? If there are branches, there are branch nodes बनते हैं, branch nodes formations होते हैं, ठीक है? Internodes, they help in formation of internodes. This can be understood if you have a bamboo tree. Bamboo tree have two things like this, and these are known as nodes. Okay, and this is known as internodes. Now nodes, increment in nodes and internodes are attributed to intercalary meristem. Lateral meristem help in increasing the breadth of the bamboo, and apical meristem, this one part is responsible for increasing the length of the system. So the meristematic tissue is important for the increase in either in length or breadth, or in the root nodules, or in the branching system of the plant. Okay, so this is the meristematic tissue division in plants. Okay, now we are going to talk about the next one, which is known as permanent tissues. Permanent tissues. Permanent tissues are very simple. They are two types. We just had studied about them. And the first one is simple tissue, simple permanent tissue, and they are of three types. That is parenchyma. Second one is sclerenchyma. And third one is collenchyma. Okay, now parenchyma, these are loosely connected, loosely packed hote hain, loosely packed tissues. Thik, loosely packed tissues, they are responsible for giving strength to plant. Okay, strength to plant, loosely packed hote hain, they are somewhat hard packing, and the important thing is they are made up of pectocellulose. This question has been asked ki sclerenchyma is made up of which type of material. So you need to understand that this is made up of pectocellulose, and they are hard packing, so they help in the strengthening of plant. Okay, these are responsible for strengthening of plant. Collenchyma are dead hard pack, outer surface, sometimes it is also known as outer surface. Okay, they are responsible for the protection function, protection. And one important thing, they are made up of lignin. Okay, they are made up of lignin. So there are three questions. One is parenchyma, which are loosely packed, is responsible for the strength of plant. Sclerenchyma, they are made up of pectocellulose. Okay, pectocellulose important for strengthening of plant. Okay, now the cholenchyma is made up of lignin, which is dead hard and packed hoti hai, which is also known as outer surface. Or main kaam kya hota hai? Protection ka hota hai. They help in protection of the plant. Okay, now if we talk about the second part, which is known as complex, now they have two parts. One is xylem and another one is phloem. Okay, this is also known as plumbing system of the plant. Plumbing system of plants simply means they transfer water and mineral in the plant. Further, if we talk about phloem, so they are responsible for transfer of dissolved food material. Okay, they are responsible for dissolved food material, and therefore they are transferring something from root system to the shoot system, and therefore they are known as vascular bundles. Okay, they are found in between like this. This is if we cut one of the plant, and if we find like this, this is what is known as vascular bundles. Okay, vascular bundles, isme phloem and parenchyma will be there, and they will help in water and mineral transport and dissolved food material transport. One more question is being asked from this part, that how does the virus transfer in the plant. Okay, virus transfer in the plant, so virus transfer in the plant from phloem. Always remember, this question is being asked by UPSC. UPSC examination, that how does the virus are transferred in the plant. The virus are being transferred in the plant from phloem. Okay, in the form of dissolved food material, they get entered into it, and that get transferred from one part to the another part of the body. Okay, so this is all about the plant system, plant tissue system, and now we are going to talk about the animal tissue system. Okay, now this is animal tissues. Now, animal tissues are very important because most of the questions are being asked from this system. And the first animal tissue is known as epithelial tissue. Epithelial tissue is simply the covering of the body. Covering of the body or various body parts. Okay. Various body parts. This simply means that it help in the isolation of various organs. Okay, isolation of various organs simply means your heart is other from your lungs, your kidney is other from the alimentary canal, your liver or your from pancreas or from gallbladder. Everything is isolated from one another, yet they are connected with other things. But if we talk about the organ system, then this epithelial learning tissues, what they are making? They are making the covering of the body. Okay, covering of various body parts with compartmentalization. They help in formation of compartment. Okay, they help in the formation of compartment. So, and for example, there are various type of epithelial tissue systems which are important. First one is simple tissue system, simple epithelium. Example is skin. Okay, your skin is a simple epithelial tissue, simple covering, nothing else. Now the second one is squamous epithelium is like this. There will be cells with some villi. There will be cells with some villi, okay, and these villi help us in brushing of the important things, that so that most of the things get stagnant here and not proceed further. Okay, so this is found in oesophagus, which is known as food pipe in the body. They are found in tracheal system, which is present in your trachea. Okay, another one is cuboidal tissue is like cube like structures. They are present in smooth muscle lining. okay, smooth muscle lining, they are present in smooth muscle lining. One is known as columnar tissue. Columnar is like similarly like cuboidal tissue, but they have the long elongated hair, elongated cells. Okay, these type are found in various tissue linings, various organ linings. And lastly, important is glandular epithelium. Glandular, they are present only in gland system, glandular system. Like if this is a gland, then there will be a glandular system. So there will be a tissue lining like this. Okay, this is present in all types of glands, right? So these are the epithelial tissues which are important and been asked. Simply the question is being asked in squamous epithelium, simple epithelium and glandular epithelium. So you should know about the simple epithelium. It is present only in skin. Another one is squamous epithelium, which is present in oesophagus, and the other one is glandular epithelium, which is present in glands, all type of gland. Most of the glands have these type of glandular systems, and this form the outer lining of the organ system or the particular organ system. Okay, now we are going to talk about the muscular system. The another one is muscular system. Okay, muscular system. Now the muscular system has three type of muscles. Okay, now the simple first one is known as skeletal muscles. Another one is known as smooth muscles. And the last one is known as cardiac muscles. Okay, these are voluntary in action. Voluntary in action simply means, aapki marzi par ye kaam karenge. They will act according to your will, according to will. Okay, like you want to move, and for moving you need some muscles, and these muscles are attached to your skeletal system, which are known as skeletal muscles. Okay, now these are the smooth muscles. They are also known as serrated muscles. Okay, they are known as unserrated muscles, and they do not depend upon your will, okay, they will do their own work, like blinking of eyes, you are not controlling it. Breathing sensation, you are not controlling the breathing. If you are sitting normally and studying right now, then the breathing system automatically happens. You are not doing that voluntarily. Okay, so this is the thing that you cannot control. So smooth muscles are present there where you cannot control the actions. Skeletal muscles are present there where you have to control the system. Now these are the cardiac muscles, which are special type of muscles which are present only in cardiac. Okay, only in cardiac. They have the power of constant contraction and relaxation, and help in the contraction and relaxation of the cardiac, which pumps the blood to the body, right? So this is known as muscular system. There are three type of muscles. Now if we talk about the other system, which is known as nervous system. Now nervous system has a tissue unit known as neuron. Okay, its unit is known as neuron, and neuron is the longest cell in the body, in the human body. If we talk about the longest cell in the human body, that is neuron, and this neuron contains two parts. One is known as cyton and another one is known as axon. Okay, cyton has one important part known as dendrite, and axon has one important part known as axon terminal. Dendrites is where the impulse enter, aur yahan se impulse exit. Okay, impulse exit. If we see the structure of this nervous system, then you will find like this, something like this. This is the structure of neurons. Okay, neuron is a very important part, and this is required for the sensation in the body, or the movement of sensation in the body. Okay, now this is the axon terminal part. Okay, here are some of the cells are present. These cells are known as Schwann cells, okay, myelin sheath. Actual mein ye this, there is a sheet, this sheet is known as myelin sheet. Myelin sheet. And one question is asked, which cells are present in myelin sheath? Then the cells are Schwann cells. Schwann cells, okay. Now here is the nucleus part, and this part is known as cyton, and the remaining this part is known as exon. Okay, this part is known as exon. And if you are seeing like this, this is you can see this. If you are observing this very closely, then you will find one thing important here. There is a node. This node is present, and this node is known as nodes of Ranvier. Nodes of Ranvier. Okay, nodes of Ranvier. This is important parts, and these nodes of Ranvier are present in brain, and spinal cord. And due to which, this is the important reason why the impulse are transferred in brain very fast. Why the impulse travel very fast in the brain system and spinal cord system, right? So due to the presence of Ranvier's, nodes of Ranvier's, the impulse are transferred from one part of the brain to the another part in a very less time, okay? In a fraction of second it gets transferred, right? So this is the nervous system of the human body, and the rest of the nervous system we will study in the nervous system, in which we will study about the brain system, spinal cord, how the nerves transferred, what are motor neurons, what are sensory neurons, and how they help in body sensation, right? So we will study that in the original class. Okay, now let us see what last part. Now the last part is known as connective tissue. Okay, connective tissue. Last part is connective tissue, and this connective tissue is known as, in Hindi it is known as Sanyoji Utak. Sanyoji Utak. Sanyoji Utak. नाम से पता चल रहा है, इफ यू थिंक अबाउट द नर्व कनेक्टिव टिश्यू, दैट कनेक्टिव टिश्यू मेनली फॉर्म्स द कनेक्शन इन द बॉडी, राइट? कीपिंग द बॉडी इन द सेम सिंक कंडीशन इज इम्पॉर्टेंट, राइट? इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द पीएच वैल्यू, इफ यू सी द पीएच वैल्यू ऑफ योर स्किन, ओके, इफ यू सी द पीएच वैल्यू ऑफ स्किन ऑफ योर दिस हैंड, नाउ द पीएच वैल्यू ऑफ द स्किन ऑफ दिस हैंड विल बी द सेम, ओके. This is known as sink condition, matlab keeping the body in the all similar condition, and this is the important work of connective tissue. An example of connective tissue is blood, and most of the questions have been asked from this blood. Another example tissue is adipose tissue, okay, adipose tissue, and this adipose tissue is present just below the skin, okay, just below the skin it is present. Another one example is tendons, right? They are present in skeletal muscles and bones, muscles to bone. They join the muscle to bone, like skeletal muscles. These are the skeletal muscles, and these skeletal muscles are joined to bones. Okay, bones via tendons. Got it? Uske baad aata hai ligaments. Ligaments forms the bone to bone connection. Bone to bone connection. Okay, bone to bone connection. If we talk about bone to bone connection, so they are important for bone to bone connection. Another important part if you talk about is fibers and fibroblast. Okay, then again we talk about bones. So these are the parts which are known as connective tissues. Okay, fibers, fibroblast, bones, blood, adipose tissue, tendons, ligaments. They are important for connective tissue. They form the connective tissue of the body. Okay, rest are the nervous tissue and the muscular tissue and the epithelial tissue. Right. So this is the overview of the plant tissue system and the animal tissue system, and I hope that you have understood each and every part of it. If there is any issue regarding the concept or the things you do not understand, comment in the section, comment section mein bataiye, and I will be coming again to solve all those problems, right? So also tell me what next lesson would you like to study, and from my side I will be discussing the connective tissue, mainly the blood part, because this is the important part and various questions have been asked from this topic, right? So keep subscribing our channel and do share our channel, okay, so that you can get valuable content for study for UPSC and SSC topics. Okay, so all the very best, keep learning and keep sharing the classes. Thank you.